Dear participants, dear organizers, dear ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to greet you warmly on behalf of the Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry and Food of the Republic of Slovenia and on my own behalf. I want to extend my warmest congratulations to the successful convening of the conference, my sincere pleasure to be with you and share with you some ideas and gratitude to the organizing committee for the organization of the event. Due to pandemic COVID-19 situation, we are facing today with a new reality resulting in audio-video conferences all over the Europe and beyond. The whole situation surrounding the COVID-19 still appears very uncertain and remains of the restriction of movements beyond our national borders is still necessary. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to underline the role of agriculture in the development of tourism, the importance of integrating locally produced food into tourism, and introduce you with the necessary measures which have been undertaken by the Slovenian Ministry of Agriculture. Slovenia is a land of green areas with an ecologically preserved countryside and cultural diversity. In such a reference environment, the tourist offer of the Slovenian countryside, tourist farms with the vines and local gastronomy makes an important contribution to the development of Slovenian tourism in its entirety. The countryside has the function of a space for living, working, settling, and cultural and social activities. Some of us have the opportunity to live on a farm that, in addition to work, also offer many business and development opportunities to the local population. In Slovenia, the Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry and Food, together with its affiliated bodies and the Chamber of Agriculture and Forestry and the Agricultural Advisory Service, is responsible for the development of tourism on farms. In Slovenia, rural tourism is one of the 10 main products in the strategy of Slovenian tourism. This type of tourism is the trend, as it offers genuine contacts with nature and people, which is increasingly sought by people from urban centers. In 2019, more than 100,000 guests visited tourist farms, generating more than 250,000 overnight stays. As many as 80% of all guests staying overnight on these farms were foreigners. The strategy for the sustainable growth of Slovenian tourism adopted by the government of the Republic of Slovenia in October 2017 emphasizes the vision that Slovenia is a global green boutique destination seeking diverse and active experiences, inner peace and personal benefits. In Slovenia, tourism is a typical cross-sectoral activity where individual ministers participate in all measures of the strategy and have even assumed responsibility for delivering several of them. As I have already mentioned, the Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry and Food is responsible for the development of rural tourism. Rural tourism is part of the strategy for the sustainable growth of Slovenian tourism. It includes authentic cuisine offered by hospitable hosts on tourist farms and in local inns. Since 1997, the Association of Tourist Farms of Slovenia has been responsible for the marketing of tourist farms to domestic and foreign guests. The association received financial support for its activities from the Ministry of the Economy and the Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry and Food, and promotional support from the Slovenian Tourist Board. The Association of Tourist Farms of Slovenia, which today has around 400 members, is an important promoter, educator, developer and accelerator of the diversity of experiences and the quality of the offer on tourist farms. The association cooperates with consultants for farming families and the development of supplementary activities who are employed with regional agriculture and forestry institutes. The association also cooperates with experts from the Chamber of Agriculture and Forestry of Slovenia. In Slovenia, rural tourism and hospitality activities on farms are carried out as supplementary activities on farms. There are now more than 1,000 farms registered for this activity. These have an average of 11.6 hectares of agricultural land. On average, four adults and children live on these farms. These are family farms where several generations live together. The hospitality activities carried out include tourist farms with accommodation, excursion farmers, wine shops and osmica farm products events. All of these activities are all based on the provider's own grown and processed food. We also support tourist farms within the framework of the policies and measures under the Rural Development Program 2014-2020. Here I refer in particular to support for investments in the establishment and development of non-agricultural activities. In the context of measures to mitigate the consequences of the COVID-19 pandemic, financial compensation was brought to the rural tourism farm sector due to the loss of income resulting from the ban on activities. Such businesses received financial compensation in the form of flat rate compensation based on the average income of the last year. This type of tourist activity is also associated with gastronomic experiences. Along with sustainable management, the overall marketing effort provides new jobs and has a long-term impact on generation renewal, appropriate settlements and entrepreneurial opportunities in Slovenia's rural areas. Next year, Slovenia will be awarded prestigious title of the 2021 European Region of Gastronomy. We look forward to this title. This will facilitate cross-sectoral integration in the areas of food policy, gastronomy, hospitality, tourism, agriculture, health, education and sustainable principles. The Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry and Food has decided to actively connect stakeholders in the field of food production within the national project of the European Region of Gastronomy 2021. Only intensive cooperation in the use of locally produced food in the hospitality industry can bring about progress in the preparation of gastronomic surpluses. Last but not least, allow me to mention another special area which we Slovenians are very proud of. We are proud that beekeeping in Slovenia has a particularly rich tradition, as honey and wax were traded on Slovenian territory in as early as the 12th century. In Slovenia, we have already developed beekeeping tourism, apitourism, which is a relatively new activity in our country. It is a combination of spa, ecological and rural tourism. It contributes to a higher quality of life, educates visitors and develops a higher degree of respect and responsibility for the natural, cultural and social environment. Beekeeping tourism is certainly an innovative approach to sustainable tourism, which is developing rapidly in Slovenia. The offers are varied. Some beekeepers have set up mini beekeeping museums. Others have planted honey flowers. Some organize tasting and sales of basic bee products, or offer their bee houses for apitherapy and places for resting and listening to the buzzing bees. Dear ladies and gentlemen, we live in a world that is changing radically. It is not possible to predict exactly what new technologies, shifts in political and economic relations, and changes in the natural environment will bring. This also includes agriculture and rural tourism. Slovenia has an exceptionally well-preserved natural environment, which is a key advantage and an opportunity to increase added value in food production, as well as an opportunity for Slovenian green tourism. Agriculture and tourism are sectors that need to work together, complement each other, and require upgrading. There is outstanding potential in Slovenia as to development of unique and experiential tourist stories through creative, traditional, or modern cuisine and gastronomy. In addition to unspoiled nature, a clean environment, and well-preserved countryside, rural tourism should also offer high-quality Slovenian food and excellent wines. Through gastronomy, Slovenian food can achieve higher added value and higher prices and incomes for farmers. At the Ministry of Agriculture, Forestry and Food of the Republic of Slovenia, we are constantly striving to find a special place for the Slovenian countryside and the possibility of economic development by restoring the reputation of Slovenian farmers in the society. We are aware that knowledge, creativity, entrepreneurship, and integration are the driving forces behind the progress of tourism in agriculture and in the whole countryside. Promoting knowledge, innovation, and digitalization in agriculture and in the countryside is an extremely important factor in development. Before I conclude, let me take this opportunity to wish that the participants and organizers of today's conference well-being and success in implementing new ideas. Thank you.